the Furman Hebrew Academy, Lower School, Erev Shabbat, O-N-E-G. Welcome to another wonderful Oneg and Step Up celebration, celebrating not just a week, but an entire year of wonderful learning. Please quietly stand and face the flags. Today we will be accompanied by Mrs. Judy Graber, who will be joining us for the Pledge of Allegiance and Hatikva. Please turn and face the Israeli flag. Please remain standing and join me for a special tefillah for our brothers and sisters in Eretz Yisrael. Bye. Please be seated.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. So, for about 30 more minutes, do we have kindergartners in this room? That's the best you can do? Do we have first graders in this room? Oh, that's much better. Second graders? Third graders? Fourth graders, where are you? And almost middle schoolers. Do we have almost middle schoolers? Wow, I don't know who put you in the front rows. That was very loud. So, Mrs. Hanloff and Mrs. Israel and the rest of the lower school faculty is a little bit sad. I'm not quite as sad. Do you know why I'm not quite as sad as Mrs. Israel and Mrs. Hanloff? Because they know that this is the last day for the fifth graders in lower school, and they are going to miss you so much next year. You might have to go visit them every once in a while, but not during class. I'm not as sad because I get to see you in the middle school all the time. And hopefully I'll get to see you for many, many years from now. So I really want to congratulate the fifth grade, really everyone, for an amazing, amazing year. I want to congratulate the parents, and I want parents, it's a little hard to see with the light on me, but those of you who have your oldest child going to middle school, raise your hand. Wow, quite a number of you. All right, so a special b'hatzlacha, special good luck to the parents who are having their first middle school child. It's quite a ride. And to all of you lower school students, I want to make sure that you have a wonderful summer. I want to make sure that every once in a while you do an act of chesed, maybe opening the door for somebody, giving tzedakah, helping somebody out. I want to make sure that you read a little bit so you don't forget how to read. Make sure that you learn a little bit of Torah, maybe Parshat HaShavua, or learning with your rabbi, or learning with your parents. And I also want to make sure that you have some fun over the summer. So make sure to have some fun. I know that's a really tough job. So welcome to all the parents. Mazal tov to all of you who are moving up into middle school, and have a wonderful, wonderful summer.
Thank you so much, Dr. Levis, and please welcome to our stage our lower school girls choir.
To 10th grade?
Yes?
No.
So long, farewell, goodbye.
Thank you so much to our girls' choir.
Boker Tov, friends. Mazal Tov, especially to our fifth grade. I was once asked a question: what is the most beautiful part of a synagogue? If you had to think about it, what is the most beautiful part of the synagogue? Some people said, maybe it's the beautiful voices of the children singing. That was so beautiful. Or other people say, maybe it's the windows, and in some shuls, the stained glass windows. And other people talk about the architecture, or just the people themselves. Some people think about the voice of the chazan or the bal korei. There are lots of things that could be beautiful. Everybody thinking about one thing? But I want to tell you what I think is the most beautiful part of a synagogue. Can I tell you? I think the most beautiful part of a shul are the ramps. The ramps that allow a wheelchair to get inside the shul. The ramps that may allow, and may not in all of ours, but maybe we should consider it, to allow a wheelchair or a walker or someone that has arthritis and bad knees come up all the way to the Aron or to the Bima. Not just ramps to allow for accessibility, to allow people to get to where they want to get to. But what about books that have Braille in it, so that if someone is blind, they can daven from the Siddur? Or what about having an interpreter who can sign from the front of the shul what is happening to those that can't hear? The most beautiful part of a shul is the way we create access, the way we give people who can't always get into shul the same way we can, give them an opportunity too. And when I was thinking about a step-up ceremony, you know what's interesting about a step-up ceremony? Is that not everybody can get up the five stairs on the side. And especially, I'm thinking today about my son, Elyon, who broke his foot. And I want to thank so many of the fifth graders that have taken the time to push him around the last few weeks of school. And as we think about a step-up ceremony, let's remember that we have to help lots of people step up in different kinds of ways. And that's my bracha to you all.
And now it's time for our weekly Shabbos Smile with Mrs. H.
I can still say good morning, right? John? It's not working. Max? I can use this one. All right. This year in the lower school, Mrs. Koss left us with a beautiful tradition every day. On Monday, we put a joke on the whiteboard. On Tuesday, you get an answer. On Wednesday, you get a joke. On Thursday, you get an answer. And we started this year on Friday, you get a live joke from a student or a visitor, depending if you visit with us on Onik Shabbat. And the way that it works is the students will tell the joke, you'll repeat it, and the students will give you an answer. And we're gonna start, Toby and Lizzie submitted the funniest jokes and won the opportunity to share a joke with you.
I can remember when you fit in the palm of my hand. You felt so good in it. No bigger than a minute. How it amazes me. You're changing with every blink. Faster than a flower blooms. They grow up all too soon. So let them be little. Cause they're only that way. Give them hope, give them praise, give them love every day. Let them cry, let them giggle, let them sleep in the middle. Oh, but let them be little. I never felt so much. One little tender touch. I live for those kisses, your prayers and your wishes. And now you're teaching me how only a child please. Please let them be little. Cause they're only that way.
שפע וברכה על המשפחה כל כולי רק בזכותך דע לך, דע לך שמודה אני לך
Middle schoolers, that was amazing. That was amazing.
Okay. Something that we always like to do together is show our Hakarat HaTov for all of the, to all the special people who helped us to work together to make something as beautiful as this happen. And also we want to show our Hakarat HaTov to the people who helped us have such a wonderful school year together. So we're going to start with asking just for a moment for our teachers and assistants to please stand up so we can clap for them.
Toda raba.
All of our teachers and assistants. We want to especially mention Moradina Agassi and Mrs. Jaddick, who have spent their last school year here with us this year. Moradina Agassi has been here for 5 years, and Mrs. Jaddick has been teaching in our school for 40 years, which is amazing. We also want to thank all of the other people who are really our friends who help us make everything work here at school. Mrs. Trencher, Mara Oneg, Mara Atara, Mr. Newman. We want to thank Rabbi Pepper especially for always helping make such a special Oneg Shabbat and all of our other amazing programs in Lower School. And for your beautiful Step Up program, we want to thank all of your fifth grade teachers, especially the Benot Sherut and Mar Oshrat, who really worked on your beautiful singing and dancing here today. And we're very, very proud of how that came out. We also want to thank Mrs. Graber, who always makes our special programs tinkle. and Mrs. Horowitz for her beautiful work with the girls' choir. Okay. And Mrs. It's that moment you've all been waiting for, I think.
Mrs. Israel, can you believe we made it to the end of the school year?
This is the last day of school, Mrs. H, and I think, I'm not sure, but I think we remembered to do almost all the things that Mrs. Koss told us to do.
I think so, but you know, there's something about the end of the school year.
Oh, she did
say something. And a ceremony, and we have to move the students from one place to another. I'm not sure.
Oh, this is hard to remember. There is a thing, like we're supposed to do a thing, right?
Oh, you know, I have a bag full of stuff from school. Maybe there's something in here that can help me.
We're supposed to have stuff. We're supposed to have.
I have a red, white, and blue spatula. Will that work?
Oh, that's not, we're not supposed
Will
to wave.
Will that work, Yeladim?
Should we wave the spatula? No, I don't think that's it, Mrs. H. I don't think it's a spatula, but that reminds me of how wonderful Veterans Day was here in our school. I think you're right. I found something. Maybe we should wave this at them.
A loaf of bread?
I found
Why
a loaf of bread.
That?
Should we wave that at you, Yeladim?
I don't think the loaf of bread is right, but that reminds me of all the times this year we sang beautifully in the cafeteria, the Birkat HaMazon. We had Rabbi Pepper join us this year, and he taught us the Birkat Baby. Many of you got to hear it yesterday. That reminds me of that, but I don't think that's going to work. Let me see what else I have. I think I have the dismissal umbrella.
Oh, I don't think we should wave the umbrella at them either, Mrs. H. I just don't think that's going to work. But dismissal is always fun in the lower school. Inside and outside and rain and snow and hurricanes and all.
Do you have anything else in your bag?
I do. I found a camera. Should we wave the camera?
Oh, that's not going to work, but I think we should take a selfie. Can we take a selfie?
Nope, it's not a camera. You're right, Mrs. H.
You know what? I have the red wiffle ball bat.
Nope, it's not. It's not that.
That won't work either. Will that work? No.
No, it's not that. Okay, I think I found it.
I found it too. Are you ready? One, two, three.
Woo! I have a lightsaber. Will that work?
No,
it's not it. Oh, Mrs. Koss, we're trying to remember. What else do we have in here?
One more thing.
Oh, I have one more thing too. Let's pull it out together.
One, two, three. I have a magic wand. Do you have a magic wand?
I found a magic wand in here. Mrs. Koss gave this to me. She did. This is the magic wand from Mrs. Koss. Should we try this?
I think this might work.
This might work.
So do you see we need a special guest? I told him 11:15.
Yes, he's here. I saw him. Okay. He's here. I see
him. I'm on the dot. Check that out. All right.
Well, let's start with these friends since they're sitting right here.
All right. Fifth graders, please stand.
Okay, we're going to wave our magic wand, and all of a sudden you are going to be middle schoolers, and you are going to go down the steps to be with Rabbi Shields.
One, two, three.
Ooh, okay, down the steps.
Head down, start heading
down. There you go.
Kindergartners.
Okay, kindergarten, please stand up. Kindergarten. Are you ready to be first graders? Okay. You're first graders.
Please stand. Are you ready to be second graders? All right, you are second graders. Have a seat.
Okay, second grade, please stand up. Okay, a big cheer from the second grade. Are you ready, second grade? Yes. Okay, second grade is now a third graders.
Are you ready to be fourth graders? You're fourth graders.
Okay, fourth grade.
Please stand. Woo! How many days until the fifth grade Shabbaton? 188. Are you ready to be fifth graders?
Yay.
Miss one?
Yes.